do you follow a toss like that? Well, we're going to try, because this morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we're celebrating wedding week with a very happy couple who is on their 24th year of marriage. We have Chef George Damani and his wife, Reggie, from Portsmouth Publick House. Welcome.
Thank you.
Look how dapper they are. They got all dressed up for wedding week.
Wedding week, you want to look kind of, you know,
festive.
Better than a chef coat.
You're looking your best because you're doing, you know, a lot of entertaining around this time of year, especially if you are a bride and groom. You're having a lot of people over. There are a lot of events, and the recipe that you have is great. Yeah, a great favor for them.
It really is. It's I think it's a great application for bridal showers, for even a dessert table at the wedding at your wedding venue, even for a takeaway, because it's really what it is. It's a mason jar filled with a pie, you know,
so. And the pie that we're making today, Reggie, you are the woman to see because you're in charge of all of the desserts here. So take us through the ingredients of what we need for
so
the pie.
So today, I made different variations there, but today we're doing a key lime pie in the mason jar. So we have a pretzel crust that we'll be melting with butter and sugar. And then we're going to move into the main ingredient, which is, it's almost like a custard. And then once that's finished, we're going to top it with a whipped cream with tequila in it and some salt. Some sea salt that's going to go on top.
These are fresh limes.
Little pipettes that will be filled with tequila.
Doesn't get any better than that. All right, it's a great gift for your guests, and we'll show you how to make it coming up. We've got a great dessert for all of your wedding guests and even a wedding favor, something that they can go home with. Key lime pie.
That's correct.
In a mason jar.
Yes.
Yep. Great idea.
Yeah, it is. It's an awesome idea. It's a good treat. It's unexpected, but yet it's kind of that whole mason jar look is in right now, that hipster thing is. Is happening.
A rustic feel to it. Exactly.
So what we did in the last segment in between is we took the pretzels, the salted pretzels, and we mashed them up with the melted butter.
Okay.
And then we just filled it in the jar.
A little bit of sugar as well.
A little bit of sugar.
So that's our first layer.
Bind it all together.
Yep, that's the first layer.
All right, you can use the large jars or the small jars. Then we have the egg yolks.
Okay.
I'm just going to add in the sweetened condensed milk.
That's thick, huh?
Yes, it is. Nice and sweet.
This is what you said is going to be kind of like a custard.
It actually turns into, it's like a key lime pie, but it really is thick, like the consistency of a custard. And then we have the juice of one lime.
Okay. You need that natural flavor in there.
And of course, the zest of one lime. And the most important, we're going to do 1 ounce of tequila.
Oh, yeah.
Because I was thinking even like a bachelorette party, girls' night out.
A lot of events happen from, you know, by the time you get engaged. Heck, some people even have engagement parties.
Mm-hmm. Yes, absolutely.
So there's always something to do.
True. And then once that's all mixed, all we're going to do is we're going to fill it into the jar.
Okay.
And divide it up evenly.
You can ladle it in, or you can just pour it down.
No, I'm going to give it to you.
And this is going to bake in the oven for about 15 minutes. So this is something they could even do if they're planning a bridal shower. They could do this the day before. Cook it all and put it in the refrigerator.
And then the next
day, add the whipped cream to it. It'll already be chilled.
Ooh, excellent. All right, well, there you go. We've got these pretty much done. We're going to throw them in the oven, top them off in our last segment, and tell you more about everything going on at Portsmouth Publick House. Back to you. All right, back in the Rhode Show kitchen with a very happy couple in honor of wedding week. We have George and Reggie from Portsmouth Publick House and a great dessert.
Yes, it is.
Remind everyone what went into these little mason jars, or a bigger mason jar if you're feeling extra hungry.
So what we did is that it's layered. So the bottom layer is the salted pretzel, you know, with the butter inside of it. And this is the batter that you made earlier. We pour it in the jar. You bake it in the oven for about 15, 20 minutes.
Great.
And the secret is you want to make sure it's no longer jello-y, like when there's no wiggle to it.
Yeah, it's just set. There's no jello left to it.
Okay.
And you'll know it's done.
You pull it out and you want to refrigerate it overnight. You know,
okay.
That way it sets up perfectly. It's nice and cold.
Yeah.
And so the day before your event or even probably, this has probably got a shelf life of what, like a week?
Yeah, I would say.
So if you
want to start prepping early, get everything ready.
Yeah.
That's nice, especially with the number of guests that you may be inviting to some of these events. You never really know. Start early.
That's very true.
And Reggie, you were busy whipping away.
So we made some whipped cream. I like to add a little confectioner's sugar to my whipping cream. Gives it a little sweet taste.
Huh.
And then I mixed in some lime zest and, of course, some tequila.
Yes, because these are our key lime tequila pie in a mason jar. Woo! What's going on there? You put it in a piping bag.
So if you want to just pipe it in there.
Oh, well, me. Okay. All right. Oh, gosh.
There.
Here we go.
I don't know if the judge made that hole big enough.
Whoa!
And we just, it just gives a nice little decorative touch. Now, if you wanted to leave it flat and then put the lid on, you could do that, or you can go higher up for
display. I'll go higher up.
Bring it right up. It's whipped cream. Homemade.
There we go. I know. There's nothing better than homemade whipped cream. Plus, you can see those little specks of lime in there, so it really kind of ties the whole flavor together.
And you can smell the tequila.
Yeah.
That's right.
Probably because I had the jar right by my nose.
But you added tequila. To the custard,
to the filling,
and to the whipped cream as well,
and to the whipped cream.
Yeah. So the custard
one. This is definitely a 21.
Yes, this is a 21 and over dessert.
Yes, and then what we do?
It's really, really good,
isn't it?
To finish it off, we get these pipettes, and you can just order these online. Mm-hmm. You know, they're just like little eyedroppers, but they're disposable.
Okay.
You know, so what you do is you just fill your glass up with your spirits of choice,
mm-hmm.
and you just.
I have to tell you, it takes a few practices. George is here.
And then what you do is you just take it and you jam it in.
So you don't pinch it until you allow the guest.
Yeah, your guest does
it.
And then
it fun.
And then you put the little salt on because now you've got you think about a tequila shot. You have your lime, mm-hmm. your salt, and your tequila. So you just put a little bit of the sea salt on it. So
what
now when your guest is eating it, you know, they can either infuse it or they can just do the shot in their mouth and then eat the cream.
What an interactive dessert.
That's really
too. That's great. Reggie, you have other flavors over there which we got to talk about.
Yes, that's a Heath bar. So it's a dark chocolate cake that I make with homemade salted caramel and a whipped cream. And I the same thing, I blend the Heath bar and the whipped cream.
Sure. Yeah, of course you want to try that.
And then you have another one here. Limoncello, I think.
That one
you
is
said?
Limoncello. And that one actually, so I actually made a lemon pudding and I made the limoncello in the pudding as well.
Okay.
And then I did a mousse on the top with more limoncello in it.
Yum. And George, we got to get to those fun festive drinks over there too.
So John,
we know 4th of July is coming around. Ready for it.
You know, John and Mark at the bar are always coming up with cool drinks. And these are just two festive drinks. This is the blue margarita. Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
John, our bartender, is right next to me because obviously I'm in the kitchen. And our blue margarita and then what's this one, John?
Coconut
cake martini. So it's made with the birthday cake vodka and
but again,
stuff like
fun
yeah.
drinks
yes.
that maybe you could incorporate into your running
special
events.
Special drink of the day.
Well, it's all about making the event special
great.
For you and your guests,
mm-hmm.
you know, because it's your one time.
Customize you know, everything. Yeah, it is your
we've
special
been
day.
24 years we've been married, and I remember our wedding day like it was yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
yeah, you want to make those memories.
You want to make those memories so it's lasting forever.
This is a good memory, but I don't think it will last forever because I'm about to eat it in just a minute. If you want this recipe, head on over to the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.